But this is inferior nature. And there is another superior nature. What is that, sir? Jiva Bhuta, this living energy. These rascals do not know that there are two natures working, material nature and spiritual nature. The spiritual nature is within the material nature, therefore it is working. Otherwise, material nature has no power to work independently. This simple thing, the so-called scientists cannot understand. So, here in this material world, asmin bhave, bhave asmin, saptame, adhikaran, asmin, in this material world, bhave asmin, krishamananam, everyone, every living entity is working hard. Hard or soft, it doesn't matter. One has to work. It doesn't matter. Just like we are also working. It may be soft, but it is also work. But it is practicing, therefore it is work. We should not take this work. Bhakti is not actually the fruitive activities. It appears like that, it is also working. But the difference is, when you are engaged in devotional service, you will not feel tired. And the material work, you will feel tired. That is the difference, practical. Materially, you take one cinema song and chant, so after half an hour you will be tired. And Hare Krishna gone chanting 25 hours. He'll never be tired. Is it not? Let's see practically. You take one's material name, Mr. John, Mr. John, Mr. John, how many times you'll chant? 10 times, 20 times, finished. But Krishna, 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 go on chanting. You'll get more energy. That is the difference. But the foolish person, they think they are also working like us. They are also doing like us. No, that is not. So they try to understand, material nature means anyone who has come here in this material world. It is not our business to come here. But we have desire to come here. That is also mentioned here. Krishamananam avidya kama karma bhi. Why they have come here? Now avidya. Avidya means nescience. Ignorance. What is that ignorance? Kama. Kama means desire. They are meant for serving Krishna, but they desire. Then why shall I serve Krishna? I shall become Krishna. This is avidya. This is avidya. Instead of serving, that is natural, sometimes it comes, just like a servant is serving the master. He is thinking, if I could get such money, then I could have become a master. That is not unnatural. So when the living entity thinks he is coming from Krishna, Krishna bhulya jeev bhogavan chakare. When he forgets Krishna, that is material life. That is material life. As soon as one forgets Krishna, then we see so many, not many, some of our students, they think, well, why should I work in this mission? Let me go. He goes away, but what does he do? He becomes a motor driver, that's all. Instead of getting honor as brahmachari, sannyasi, he has to work just like ordinary worker. So, avidya kama karma bhi. Kama. Kama means desire. Just like so many scientists, they are researching for new food. Just like our scientist friend was talking this morning. Then what is new food? Food is already there, allotted by Krishna, that you are this animal, your food is this, you are this animal, your food is this. So far human being is concerned, their food is also designated, that you take prasadam, patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam, jumi, bhakta, prajacchati. It is the duty of the human being to accept prasadam. Prasadam means food stuff which is offered to Krishna first. This is civilization. If you say, why should I offer? That is uncivilized. It is gratefulness. If you offer to Krishna, then you are conscious that these foodstuff, these grains, these fruits, these flowers, this milk, it is given by Krishna. I cannot produce it. In my factory, I cannot produce all these things. Anything one eats, nobody can produce. It is given by Krishna. Eka jo bahunam vidudhati kaman, this kaman. Now we are desiring, and Krishna is supplying. Without His supply, you cannot get it. Just like in our India, after independence, the leaders thought, now we have got independence, we shall increase the tractors and other agricultural implements, and we'll get enough food. Now, at the present moment, since 2 years, there is scarcity of no water, there is no rainfall. So these tractors are now crying. You see, it is useless. Simply by so-called tractors, implements, you cannot produce unless there is favor by Krishna. He must supply water. That for one time, recently the news is that people are so desperated that they went to the secretary, they demanded food, and the result was they were shot down. Yeah, so many people died. So, actually, although we have got this arrangement that one has to work, but that work is simple. If you remain Krishna conscious, that after all Krishna is supplying the foodstuff, that's a fact. Every religion accepts that, just like in Bible it is said, God gives us our daily bread. That's a fact. God is giving. You cannot manufacture bread. You can manufacture bread in the bakery, but the wheat supply you the wheat, that is supplied by Krishna. Eko jo bahunam vidudhati kama. So we have created unnecessary problem simply by forgetting Krishna. This is the material nature. Bhavesh mean Krishna mana. Therefore we have to work so hard. Krishanti. There is another verse in the Bhagavad Gita. Manasasthani prakitisthani karasati. Karsati, you are struggling very hard. But ultimately, sense gratification. Ultimately. In this material world means sense gratification, because kama, kama means sense gratification. Kama, the just opposite word is love. Kama, and kama means lust, and love means loving Krishna. So that is wanted. But here in this material world, they are engaged in very, very hard work. They have invented so many factories, iron factories, melting the iron, huge machinery, and it is called Ugra Karma, Asuric Karma. After all, you will eat some bread and some fruits or some flowers. Why you have invented so big, big factories? And that is avidya, nescience, avidya. Suppose 100 years ago there was no factory, so all the people of the world were starving. Nobody was starving. In our Vedic literature, we don't find any mention anywhere about the factory. No, there is no mention. And how opulent they were, even in Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, as soon as Kamsa invited Nanda Maharaj,